These two cases presented different treatment challenges and solutions that you may often see in your practice. Maria represented a traditional case of treatment lifestyle conflict. Her plan was unsuccessful because she lacked the knowledge and resources to make the lifestyle changes that supported her treatment regimen. We evaluated her medical record and existing treatment for appropriate changes influenced by recent medications and best practices. Maria found working with the dietitian the most helpful part of her new treatment. Her diabetes management and her health both improved when her treatment plan became more manageable for her. With Marcus, we saw a similar pattern of non-adherence. However, the patient wasn't understanding the risk this posed to the success of his treatment and the betterment of his health. For Marcus, the key factors were evaluating his medical history and current treatment, and comparing it to new medications and best practices, as well as formulating a more progressive treatment plan that fit his day-to-day needs. You saw how Maria and Marcus moved along the algorithm to tailor treatment to their needs and lifestyle. If you haven't already, please download this interactive copy of the algorithm for use with your patients. We hope you will find it useful for determining how best to alter treatment for patients who are not achieving their diabetes management goals on a regular basis. Thank you for taking the time to complete this course. We hope you find the lessons and materials covered in these two cases beneficial to your own practice. All of the resources discussed in this course, including the algorithm material, are available in the References and Resource section of the course menu. You will also find links to numerous articles and other supporting evidence used to create the content we covered in this course. You have now completed the learning materials for this course. Please advance to the course wrap-up and complete the post-test, course evaluation, and attestation. Follow the instructions in each section to ensure you have completed all the necessary steps to receive CME credit for your work in this course.